Alright, so let's give it another go. Hopefully I turned off my little hide screen, and this time it'll show up. What ended up happening was I worked on this piece right here, and after an hour I went and looked, and I just had a big gray screen up there. Go figure. Live and learn. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and call this one here pretty good. It'll need some tweaking, and we'll do some other things with it. But right now I have pretty much all the individual images done here. So I'm going to move on to another letter. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so here we go. So this is the next one, the S. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and lock my E and hide it away. If I need it as a reference, I still haven't, but I'm gonna go ahead and start on my new letter S. And so we're gonna do the same thing we did with the E over here, and that's gonna be start off with that and then that layer, and then just start adding each one of these individual pieces in. And look at all those pieces. Okay. So, and I'm actually going to start it off with, I believe it's this one here. Let's see. Yep, so that's the layer. That's the original letters that I typeset for this. And I'm going to quick grab it and copy it. And lock this back down as a reference. I'm gonna go up to my E and just gonna collapse that down. And we've already got it turned off. So we got this one here. I'm gonna add another layer just in front. And that. And I don't know why I started with purple, but we'll go ahead and keep that just for grins. So I'm gonna take the stroke off. Didn't seem to work now, did it? Oh yeah, because the preview behind is the one. There we go. Okay, so I've got this, and I've got it on its own layer. Go S, G, background, and I'm going to go ahead and fill it with purple. And I forget what the opacity was. I think it was like 30. Okay, just so we have something in the background. And then I'm going to go ahead and drop it into the S. And here we go. We've got it started. And I'm going to lock it down. But I really don't need it as a reference at this point. So I'm just going to leave it there. And start another layer. And we're going to draw that sloth from scratch. Sure, why not? S for sloth. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead and that's for my buddy Bob. One day at the movie theater, he's moving slow, and I said, "What are you, some sort of rug sloth?" So let's see here, and we're going to go ahead and just label it sloth. Now this is actually because of a logo I did recently, back when Evan Eckerd was trying to work on some logos and he wanted some suggestions. I said, "What about a sloth?" And he laughed and said, "No, I'm going to do something else." So, I did it. Anyway, so it was a lot of fun. And ended up, I think, doing it kind of like a Chicago Bears style colors. So, it was fun. It was fun. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and start with that one. Top of the list here. And it's funny because I've been away from this for a while. So, I I might actually have to go back to my reference illustration to figure out all this stuff that I was putting in here. A lot of it I recognize, but there's a few things that are like, okay, that's a musical note, I get that. That's a snowball mic, I get that. I don't know if this is supposed to be a football, I don't remember. And that's a brain there, I know that much. I don't know. Could be something else. Like I said, I've got the original here someplace. Let's see. Oh, stretch. And there it is. Let's take a peek. See if it makes more sense. Oh, that's a heart there. It's a heart with stitches. Okay. I'm not 100% sure why I did that. That letter there. That looks like, oh, I know what that is. Okay. Alright. So, sometimes you just have to look at the original and go, oh yeah, I remember when I was drawing that. So, here's the original. I'll just keep it close by in case I need a reference. Alright. So, anyway, so we're going to go ahead and get a move on, and with this being an illustration, there won't be any need for the mouse, or very little need for one. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and get over here, start working, and this actually might be one where I do a half and flop, but it all depends. We'll see what happens. So, I'm going to go ahead and start again with my tapered line. And this one's definitely going to be hand drawn for the most part. And so, and actually, I should grab my reference. I do want it to be similar to the one I did for that logo. Because I should and I don't have it right now, I'm just going to move on and I'll go ahead and start here. So, you know, when in doubt, draw a skull. And I've been doing that for a while. It's like, oh, I don't know what I want to draw today. How about a skull? And consequently, there's been a lot of skulls drawn. Alright, so here we go. We got our layer here. I'm going to lock down the background. Yep, so right now all I'm doing is working in here, so it should keep us out of trouble. Alright, so let's see. We're going to go ahead and work on this. So he's looking upwards, and I don't think I want to do that. So I'll do this. This. And this. And make the ridge, and I don't like it. So I'm just going to put that up like that. And let's see. We want maniacal smile. And cheekbones here. And I want some more foreshortening this time around. A little tight. Let's move it out a little bit. There we go. Alright. Let's get this. I don't know if I like this ridge so much. Let's do this. Alright. Just gonna fill that in real quick like. And I'm not liking it. So let's try this. And we'll call that okay for the moment. Flat. And enlarge it a little bit from the center point. And I don't want it enlarged, I guess, as I want stretched. Looking like a kidney bean. All right. Never mind. Try it again. All right. So we want this to go like this. And this, I think I'll just raise it a little bit higher. Bring it around. Oh. Try again. Just a little bit higher this time. Alright, that's not bad. I'll put this in here. And something like that. And let's get these cheek lines lined up. And do it like that. And he's looking a little more like Casper than a skeleton. Alright, let's try this. Just yet, but we'll see what's going on. Let's go like this. So we want that. Nope. Chin like this, and this is the lip, and like this, shadowing on the back side. Alright. And let me check the phone, which I rarely do. Alright, so let's see here. Really not feeling this skull. Let's see here. Well, Just drawing a quick pencil here. Give me a pretty bowed bone. Okay. Well, I'd say I'm totally thrilled with it. Brush. Let's see. We want to. Around this. And go ahead and fill this in. Those who don't remember, the bob brush does shapes, and the pen tool, paintbrush tool does lines. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead, quick fill, and do the same thing over here, and here. And anywhere you think you need one. Right here. Okay. It's one nice thing about the blob brush. You use nice thins and then press it down. Do something consistent. Start thin and start adding pressure. And actually, give you a decent line that way too. This is the way I normally ink when I'm not trying to keep everything looking consistent with this like line. But it works. I like using it both ways. Alright, let's get rid of some of this line. And I'm gonna go back to paintbrush and go ahead and do something like that. Okay, a little of this. And this and this and this and this. Alright, so still not totally thrilled with it, but I'm going to be okay for this right now, and I can always change my mind later. But there we got our little crossbones, and actually, it's driving me nuts, so I'll go ahead and grab this one, copy, paste in front, and I'm going to go ahead and rotate it off the nose. Nope, not if it won't let me. Okay, let's see. I've got the rotation tool. Got my point selected. Or do I? Alright, let's just try it again. Okay. Okay. Let's do Control X, if it'll let me. I lied about the mouse. Right. Doesn't want to play nice with others. Let's go. Stuck again. Come on. Please release me, let me go. Come on, you can do something here. Lodge. Haven't done a save yet. Boy, it's just not cooperating. Well, there we go. Cancel. And grab this bone. I'll just group it while I'm here. Copy. Paste in front. I'm going to go ahead and reflect. Okay. Alright. And then I'm going to go ahead and rotate this. Like that, and I'm go ahead and do a rotate. I'm gonna use this as my center point. Bring it around. Okay, better. And sneak this in. There we go. All right. So we've got a skull. I don't know, it's not thrilling me at this point, and so I'll go ahead and still call it a skull instead of a sloth, and I'm going to go ahead and leave it, because I have a sneaking suspicion I'm going to go and change that later, but there you go, there's a skull. Let me hide the skull out, now what? This one I can hand draw or not. Let's see what happens when I draw it. That's my little snowball mic, the latest edition. And draw this in. Let's add a new layer. Let's call that good. And I'm looking at it, and actually it kind of goes like this. And around. Alright. Let's go ahead. And delete, because I don't like it. Let's try this again. That's better. And let's try it again. And throw an oval in here. Let's just go. Has some lines in it, and same going this way. And do it up here. Sure, adding a lot of space. Break it now. It's not quite. Alright, let's just see what happens. Good enough. Alright. Now, let's see. Do I want to draw it? Okay. J, both, enter, okay, and let's go ahead and clear that guy, stretch this out, so I'm going to go ahead and add a point there, and copy that there, so I'm going to go ahead. These two guys and delete, and I think I'm going to and close these off with circle. I'm sorry, with the pen tool. There we go. That's not shabby enough. All right. There's grabbing the point again. Get the point. Mm-hmm. There we go, finally. Y, control 0. Alright, so we got the little snowball mic there. And leave it like that, and maybe draw the leg of it here. Let's try that. Should come to the center point-ish and down. So let me see here. Where'd you go? Come back. And let's do the pen tool. And try it this way. Alright, let's see what we can do with that. Alright, so when I draw this line out here, no man's land, let's go ahead and draw a stroke on it. I'm going to do a copy and paste in front. And I'm actually going to make it a white stroke. Okay, drop that down a few points. Okay, all that good for now. Control X, Control B. There's no fill on this. And we'll try though. And let's see, shift here. And Control X, Control paste them back. Back, there we go. Alright, don't like this. So let's see if we can go down, 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 down. No, not so much. Okay, so let's see, down, down. This guy to be smaller, down, down, paste in front, and that's not terrible. So, I'm just going to grab all that, alright, we're going to call that, snow. Okay. Alright, so we got a skull I'm not thrilled with. And we got the microphone. Alright, so let's see. Next one's going to be. This one here. And. Let's do the brain. Let's do the brain. Alright, and let's go back to the paintbrush. Alright, and so we're going to go ahead and start making lines that are invisible. No. Okay. There we go. Alright. So we've got that. And so let's see about giving a texture for the brain. Let's do this other thing. texture to it. And then we just have the cord. In here and come back out. Looks like a brain. Alright, let's get back to the brain. And do a fill. And I want it to be white. Looks like it's together there. So I'm just going to grab the inside edge of this, select and do a delete, delete. And then select and do a control X, paste them back. And we got a brain. All right, so brain. All right, so that's done. And it looks like we can get another one done here. Alright, so I want a musical note. Fill black. That is okay. Let's do it like this. And grab this again. And I'm gonna hold down the shift, kick that back, kick this back. There. And we'll move this over the opposite side, select it, and do, can't do flush. That's there. Alright, let me get in here a little closer. Alright, there. And select this and move it in, maybe. There we go. And put it to the top point, top right hand side point. Alright, we'll call that good for now. And we're gonna drag again. Okay. Please, let's go back, back, back. Okay. And shift. And let's just do a group and copy. And come back here. Let's say group and copy. And we'll grab this, move it into place. And maybe enlarge it a bit. Okay. I just want to rotate. No, why is it still there? Because it's not there. Okay, let's do it like this. There we go. Okay, that gives us something to look at. Control X, I want a new layer, paste in front, and just gonna put note. Alright, so that's done. So let's see here. What I'm going to do is make a custom brush there. So I'm going to actually start with a circle. Okay, a circle. All right, so we've got that. So on this one, the highlight line is right in this area. I'm gonna have this in the dark. Okay. One way to do that is with a custom brush. And let's see. So I want that. And that's not what I want. I thought I had a pen tool again. All right, well, I think that's a good place to stop. Coming up on the hour. So this is a makeup for yesterday. Well, we got a couple of pieces done, and still want to tackle this sloth, but I'm going to grab my reference picture that I used before and worry about some of these other little details. But for now, here we are. All right, well, thanks for checking it out, and I hope you have a great day, and we'll see you on the next one. Later.